as well as the change in the pH as well as the CMCS activity was measured. When the pH dropped at the minimum level, both the qualitative as well as quantitative analysis of organic acid was performed. The detection of organic acid was first of all done by the TLC method, and then after it was performed by the HPLC. After the HPLC, we have find that there is a presence of citric acid in all the three samples. So further, it was estimated for the quantitative analysis. Now this is the primary. These are the results for the primary screening. The isolates are there. The gram reaction is there, and there is a zone size in which the 22 and 21 both were the organism which is showing the maximum zone size. Now this is a selected isolate. This is the microscopic and macroscopic observation of selected isolate, which is the Aspergillus niger. Now this is the results in which the two flasks are there, in which the one is control and the another one is a flask which contain the isolate. We can clearly observe the disintegration. The first is showing the presence of sugarcane waste. Second is showing the orange pills, and the third contain the wheat straw as a substrate. Now this is the table for the result for the sugar concentration. The sugar concentration was measured with the DNSM method. As we can observe that as the days are going, the sugar concentration is getting decreasing. This is the pH profile. As the pH is going to decrease, this is the graph which is showing time versus pH. As the time is increasing, the pH is decreasing, which is showing that there is a production of different organic acid. Now this is a TLC sheet which we have used, in which we can observe the three standards we have used, and into at the last there is a S1 and S2 which is showing the sample, and in that we can observe there is a presence of which is detecting the presence of organic acid. Now this is a chromatograph of organic acid analysis. This is a HPLC chromatograph. This is a graph of time versus absorption, and whatever the peak you can observe, it is of retardation time. This is a standard chromatographic graph, and in which we have used this five standard organic acid, that is the oxalic acid, citric acid, lactic acid, malic acid and ascorbic acid, and with the presence of this retardation time, we can identify the presence of any organic acid into sample. So into our sample 1, we have identified for the citric acid. Into sample 2, which contain the sugar cane waste as a substrate, in which we have identified for three different organic acid, that is citric acid, ascorbic acid and malic acid. And for the third one, which is wheat straw, in that we have identified the presence of citric acid. Now this is the qualitative analysis of organic acid, in which the five standard acid which we have used, the standard is there, and the three samples in which the different waste which we have used, and in that, in all the three samples, that will be a presence of, we have detect the presence of citric acid. So the citric acid was quantitatively analyzed by the method, and into that we have identified the concentration of citric acid with the waste orange pills and the sugarcane waste. It was around 200 microgram per ml, and with the wheat straw it was 100 microgram per ml. Conclusion: Aspergillus niger was found to be the most potent degrader to the fruit waste. The highest amount of sugar was detected from the orange pills. As the incubation time goes on, the sugar concentration is decreasing and the acidity into the medium is increasing. The lowest pH which was recorded, which was a 2.5 after the 8 days. By the HPLC analysis, the citric acid was detected with the growth of all the substrate, and the oxalic acid and the ascorbic acid was detected with the substrate sugarcane waste. And afterwards, the quantitative analysis of citric acid was carried out with the acetic anhydride pyridine method. Thank you.
Orange pills. glass.
Yeah.
Glass. He used the glass and iron pills.
Yes.
Iron pills is degraded by which enzyme?